Likewise, after supper, Jesus took the cup. And again, he gave thanks. And then he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, a covenant of grace. It's shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you will in remembrance of me." Jesus Christ is the cup of salvation. Jesus Christ is the bread of life. Oh God, we pray that you would pour out your blessing, your anointing upon this bread and upon this cup. May they be for us the body and blood of Jesus Christ, so that we may go forth into the world as your church, the body of Christ, ready to serve, ready to preach, teach, broadcast the truth, Lord, in 1,000 different ways of love. And we pray this in Christ's name. Amen. Now, if our communion stewards would please come. And by the way, if you need gluten-free, just come to the station where Miss Donna and I will be located right here, and we'll be happy to accommodate you with gluten-free elements. Also, if you need to be served where you are seated, just raise your hand and some of our stewards will come to you. Here we are in the month of December, and during the next month, we're going to be sharing in a lot of meals. We're going to be with family. We're going to be eating stuffing and taters and all kinds of vegetables and meats, and we're going to go on and have a big time. How does this size up in comparison to that? You're going to get a little wafer and a little juice. The world would say, eh, what a ripoff. It's interesting, though, that the meal that is most simple actually has the most power, because God is in these elements. It's His grace that we're receiving. You can't put a price on it. That is food for the Spirit, and we need it. We need it all the time. As the Holy Spirit leads you, please come to the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ. Is there anyone else? Okay.